Hello, hello. Welcome again to Pamati Tutorial. Makinig, manood at matuto. Please subscribe, like and share this video. Pa-shoutout naman kay Sir Nino and please subscribe rin kayo sa kanyang mga videos and natuturo rin siya ng mathematics. Okay. Let's continue to the introduction of sets. Then this type, I'll discuss the different types of sets. Okay. Now, review. Konting review muna tayo. Set is a collection of well-defined objects. It is a group of objects. Those are the elements or the member of the group. And it is well-defined. Kapag hindi siya well-defined, hindi siya set. Okay, there are different types of sets. The universal sets, the subsets, the null set, the finite, and the infinite sets. Okay, then in the sets, we are using the Venn diagram, which is the Venn diagram is an illustration used in mathematics to show the relationship, similarities, and difference among things or group of things. And this would be the example of the Venn diagram. Okay, this time, what is a universal set? It is a set that contains all the elements under consideration. Okay, it denotes us, which is the capital letter U, symbols, or it means universal set. Okay, example, if this would be our Venn diagram, the rectangle one is our universal set. Okay, that would be our universal set. It contains all the elements under consideration. Therefore, all the elements, which is the numbers from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Okay, those are the universal, that would be a universal set. Okay, and set A is 1, 5, and 7. Then, set B, the elements are 2 and 6. Okay, then outside is 3 and 4. Therefore, our universal sets is 2, 3. The elements are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. That is for our universal sets. Okay. Now, example. Using this Venn diagram, try to observe set A having the elements of 2, 8, 2, 5, and 8. Set B, the elements are 1, 7, 3, 6, pilitin ko 1, 7, 3, 6, 2, 5, and 8. Yan ang elements ni set B. Kasi nga, ito sa A, pasok kang B. It means lahat ng elements ni A, nandun rin kang B. Okay. Then, meron tayong mga elements outside these two sets, 4 and 9. Denotes the universal sets. Set A, the elements are 2, 5, and 8. Set B is 1, 2, 3, 6, 5, 7, and 8. But our universal set, lahat na nakang A, nakang B, at outside A and B na pasok dito sa ating rectangle. Those are the elements of our universal set. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Okay. Now, let's proceed to the second one, type of sets, which is the subset. Set A is a subset of set B if all the elements of set A are elements of set B. It denotes that symbol, which is the subset. Okay, example, we have here our Venn diagram. A, the elements are 2, 5, and 8. B, the elements are 1, 7, 3, 6, 5, 2, and 8. Then outside the two sets, 4 and 9, that would be our universal set. The universal sets is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Alam natin yan. Ako na natin i-discuss. Now, ano yung elements ni A? 2, 5, and 8. Ano yung elements ni B? 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Therefore, lahat ng elements ni A ay nandito kang B, nandito si 2, nandito si 5, at nandito si 8. Lahat ng elements ni A ay nandito kang B. Therefore, A is a subset of B. Okay? Lahat ng element ni A ay nandito kang B present yan. Therefore, A is a subset of B. Okay, para bagang sa isang grupo, may binuo rin na isa pang grupo, then yung grupo na yan ay subset ng naunang grupo. Okay. Next, create a Venn diagram to illustrate the relationship between sets. Okay, we have here our universal sets. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, and J. Set A, C, and D. Set B, H, and I. We will draw a Venn diagram. Try to observe. Walang magkapareho na elements si A at saka si B. Yan, meron bang magkapareho na elements? Wala. Therefore, hiwalay ang ating dalawang circle. Okay, universal set. Then, set A, ang elements. Set B, ang elements ni set A is A, C, and D. Elements ni B is H and I. Then, sa dalawang sets na to, ano pa ang wala ng mga sets na nandito sa universal set? Okay, wala ang F, E, B, G, and J. Okay, this would be our Venn diagram given these three sets. Okay. Now, another example. We have here the universal sets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Then set A, 2, 4, 6, 8. Set B, 1, 2, 5, 7, 8, and 9. Okay, observe. Meron tayong magkapareho. 2 at saka 8. Anong mangyayari sa ating Venn diagram ay ganito. Para siyang nag-intersect. Okay? Nagsapawan ang dalawang Venn diagram. Nagsapawan. Kasi meron tayong pareho na set A at saka B, which is 2 at 8. Okay? Now, our Venn diagram. That would be our universal set. Label muna tayo. Set A and set B. A, the elements are 2, 4, 6, and 8. Then, si B, the elements are 1, 2, 5, 7, 8, and 9. Pareho sila, may common. 2 and 8. Kaya naging ganyan ang ating Venn diagram. Then, dito ba, lahat na ba na nandito ay nasulat na? Galing dito sa universal set. Meron pang wala na number. Okay, meron pa. Those are 3. Okay, that is 3. Therefore, buo na ang ating numbers from the universal set. And this would be our Venn diagram. Given these 3 sets. The universal set, U, set A, and set B. Okay, cardinality of a set. Cardinality of a set is the number of elements in a finite set. Remember, finite. Kasi nga, cardinality. Number of elements. Number of elements. Ibig sabihin, pwede lang nating mabilang. Kapag infinite, hindi natin pwede mabilang, hindi natin makukuha ang cardinality ng set. Pero kapag pwede bilangin at mabibilang lang ang elements, then that is the cardinality of a set or finite set. The cardinality of a set, it means the number of elements. Okay? And it denotes this symbol, which is the cardinality of a set A. Okay? Cardinality of set A. Example, what is the cardinality of set A? Having the elements 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Therefore, the cardinality of set A is 7. Ilan ba lahat ang elements na nandito? 7. Therefore, the answer is 7. Okay. Example, what is the cardinality of set B? Having an element of A, E, I, O, U. Ilan ba lahat ng elements meron dito? 5. Therefore, the cardinality of set B is 5. Ganun lang ang cardinality of a set. Bilangin lang natin ilan yung elements. Okay? Let's proceed to another example. Example, determine all the subset of A whose are elements are 1 and 2. Okay? We will use this formula. 2 raised to the power of the cardinality of A. We will use the cardinality of A. Okay, where 2 is a constant and the cardinality of A is the number of elements of A set. Okay, let's have this. 2 raised to the power of cardinality of A, na ibig sabihin, 2, the cardinality of A is 2 because how many elements do we have? 2. The cardinality of A is 2, then that is 2 raised to the power of 2. Yung ibig sabihin, 2 times 2, ang sagot is 4. How many subsets do we have? If we will have A, or the set A, whose the elements are 1 and 2, there are 4 subsets. And those are the null set. Okay? The null set is considered a subset of all the elements. Okay? Then, a set which is the element is 1, followed by a set which is the element is 2, and a set which is the element is 1 and 2. How many subsets do we have now? There are 4. There are 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay. And thank you for watching Pamati Tutorial. Makinig, manood, at matuto. Do not forget to subscribe and like and share this video. Pakiclick na rin yung bell para updated kayo sa mga susunod na mga video. Okay, thank you for watching. See you next videos. Goodbye.